Tonight, we're at the 31st Praemium Imperiale Awards Ceremony by the Japanese Art Association. We're going to speak today with the laureates and get some comments.
Receiving the Praemium Imperiale is something very special in my life. First of all, because this prize recognizes so many different forms of art. Not only music, but also acting, film, sculptor, paintings, and architects. So this is, I think, an important contribution to the fact that the arts are an important bridge builder in society. And I couldn't be happier to be amongst, you know, recipients like Sofia Gubadulina, Gidon Kremer, Marta Agerich, to name just a few. Yeah, yes. Big heroes of mine, right. Of the past and present. And to young musicians, keep on dreaming and keep on following the path, because the world needs ambassadors of goodwill, ambassadors of love and harmony, and music gives us that language, so go for it.
It's always great to get an award like this, to be numbered amongst all the other past laureates. It's a very good club to be a member of. I think that the key thing is not to feel you have to understand what you're doing before you begin. Let the work teach you who you are, rather than thinking you can tell the work what to do. And the last thing is, I'm really sorry that Japan's wonderful run at the World Cup rugby is going to come to an end on Sunday. It's sad, but it's true.
Well, to be given an award by such a country as Japan is incredibly meaningful, because we look so much to the work and the culture that's done here. So it has an even greater meaning than anything else I could imagine. To be recognized by this country for us is a huge honor. And I would also say that in terms of this recognition, it's a kind of amazement that fell from the sky. Mm-hmm. I think we've never really thought about trying to win a prize or trying to be anything other than doing our job well. And so I would say for young architects, if you love what you do and you do it well, that's all that ever matters.
For young architects, I can only say an architect's life is a life of wonder and development, and it's ever unfolding, and you're ever expanding your base of knowledge and wonderment. So it's a beautiful life. And of course, relative to this award, we are humbled, and we do in fact pledge ourselves to doing more excellent work in the future to inspire others and to live up to the award. The other thing that's amazing about this country is that it chooses not to be a tiny island or a small country that's isolated, but rather to reach out to the world and to see that the world has riches. And I can only say that we've experienced that in our lives, and I wish all people, all cultures, would be able to see that as well, including most of all our own.
I'm totally overwhelmed by this amazing and very prestigious award. And I just want to say that this is the second time I'm honored in a big way by Japan. 2 years ago I got the Hiroshima Art Prize, which at the time I considered to be the Nobel Prize, but now everybody is talking about this prize being the Nobel Prize. So I feel like I've been honored twice by being given big prizes. So Japan has been so good to me, and I really feel overwhelmed with it.